Laptops have a problem. They're hot, loud, and kind of slow, which is more like three problems. But today, we are gonna solve all of them at once. And this ordinary looking brown box here is the Electronics Liquid Propulsion Package, or OPP, as I like to call it. It's a water cooling add-on that can apparently drop a laptop's temperatures by 20 degrees. But I am gonna have to see that to believe it. I'm seeing it. I'm still not sure if I believe it. But I believe I'm gonna tell you about our sponsor.
Thanks to Casetify for sponsoring this video. Casetify's new Impact and Ultra Impact cases offer drop protection, come in tons of designs, and even have an antimicrobial coating. Go to casetify.com/LTT to save 15% on your order.
Now this is not the first time a laptop has been water-cooled, and it's not even the first time we've seen a water-cooled laptop. The ASUS GX800 had this massive dock to keep its dual GTX 1080s from freaking desoldering themselves, and we have actually water-cooled the Alienware Area 51M twice. Incredibly, it survived.
Sort of.
Sort of. What's different about the Electronics LPP is that the price isn't super out there compared to a normal laptop. Wow, it's really light, actually kind of feels cheap. The water cooler is only $200, although yeah, that's not that cheap, but it's a lot better than the $5,000 premium that ASUS charged for the GX800, I guess. And the script just says YOLO vlog here. So I guess this is where we install it. Man, there's really not much to it, hey? Can I open it?
Not yet.
No? I wanna open it though. It looks like there's clips. Oh, it definitely has nasty plastic clips on it. So far, I have broken zero of the clips. Almost zero of the clips. So look at that. We've got some anti-vibration foam around the pump. We've got a 120 millimeter radiator. We've got a reservoir that is actually very thoughtfully designed and implemented. It's right above the pump, so it's always getting, even if it evaporated a bunch of the water away, it's always gonna be getting the freshest, least bubbly water. You've got a little window on the front where you can monitor your coolant level. That's really convenient. And then over on the other side, you've got, is this worth prying off just to see the 120 mil fan? Oh wow, this one's coming off way easier. Why did I even need a tool before? There it is, 120 millimeter fan. And a little control board that's going to be distributing power to our pump and our fan. And then just got a single DC input at the back there, probably 12 volt if I had to guess.
You just take the laptop power, plug it in the back and pass it through.
It passes through power to the laptop? How the F does that work? Oh, I see. So it just like siphons off some of the power being passed through this just thing that just is sticking out here.
Yeah.
I've seen dumber things. In terms of coolant routing, everything's like smart. They have someone there that is sensible and like knows water cooling, like even just little things, right? Like having the fittings up at the top, that's gonna allow the air to bleed out of it much more easily. So you've got it coming in this way, coming up here, going through the radiator and then coming out to the top of the reservoir. That's gonna create very little turbulence, which is gonna create very few bubbles in the res to be sucked back into the pump. I like it. I mean, this could be the world's cheapest, crappiest pump for all I know, but at least the layout of the loop is thoughtful. I don't know if $200 is what I would want to pay for AIO tier hardware, but something to consider is that this is going to be a pretty low volume product, I would imagine, and something's got to account for the tooling costs of creating these plastic molds. Huh, look at that. That did it. Say whatever you want about the cooling solution though. The SSD in here looks pretty good. Gen 4x4 Samsung SSD. What else we got shaken here? This looks like 32 gigs of DDR4. Wait, is this DDR5? Oh, cool. 4800. Oh, are we even allowed to like talk about this hardware yet? Because this would be 12th gen then.
Yeah, it's 12th gen.
Oh, there's a note in here. Important, this is pre-production hardware and the CPU and GPU are under embargo. We can show temps and power draw, nothing else, or NVIDIA and Intel will light a big bag of poo on fire and leave it on our front doorstep. Read you loud and clear. Now that I'm done getting distracted by the shinies, let's turn our attention to the star of the show, the integrated water cooling. The aluminum heat sinks are enough to effectively cool the laptop, but what I'm imagining is that when you add the water cooling system, the fans won't have to work as hard, which should theoretically make it quieter, and your internal temps should get lower. I mean, I can see how this could conceivably work. Look at this, you've got contact with the CPU right here, and it runs all the way over all three of these heat pipes and comes over to the GPU and then even runs over the area where your video memory and your VRMs probably are, unless the VRM's over here, and then comes out back across the CPU and out it goes. Electronics, what do they claim? Like 20 degrees improvement?
Yep.
Wow. Now, to be clear, that's not enough that you could just run it on water cooling. Like, these tubes are very secondary compared to the heat pipes that make up the air cooling system. It's just that the biggest challenge in a laptop is how little space you have to work with. So the heat sinks are always crazy small, and the fans are crazy inefficient because they have to be these super low profile fans. This takes that and ideally solves both of those problems. Nice big radiator, nice big fan. Is that the Taycan?
Yeah.
Hey, I recognized a car.
Yeah, it's even the color we had. It's,
yeah, like the exact one that I drove. Looks better in person. Well, it didn't take us long to thermal throttle. It already detected thermal throttling, so that's cool. We reached a maximum of 88 degrees on the CPU. How's our GPU doing? 82.3. GPU power, 130 watt. Alex has already run more scientific versions of these benchmarks, but I just want to experience it. Oh, well, that was easy. That, really? That's the seal? Okay, I have one more bit of advice for the engineers at Electronics. I would like to see a bit more of a permanent top seal, because this is the sort of thing that, if left unattended, a little sibling or a pet could easily knock over. And if the water did in fact come out, it could easily make its way to being sucked into the fans of your laptop. I don't like that. See, this is why brands should send us products before release. Like, the number of things like that that we could prevent. They just sent it to us, you know, on the second to last revision. Like, here's an example. I might have told them, well, this would have to be at an earlier stage, but I might have told them to put these on the back so that the tubes aren't sticking out the front. This end appears to be just a quick connect, so... Oh, look at that! That's actually kind of awesome. Then you just pull back here, and the thing pops out. Wow, this has a very engineering sample vibe to it. They literally just CA glued two different diameters of tubing together to make this filler for it. I mean, for me, I only live once, so I'm not gonna use it, but.
Jesus Christ, don't do that.
No, I will use it, I will use it. I will actually use it for a change. I'm very offended that this is here, by the way, instead of an LTTstore.com water bottle. Great water bottles. Keep your drinks cool, and you even cooler.
Hope you are not doing that every
day. Yeah, this would be not the greatest job in the world. I feel like I'd get better at it, though.
Hey, Linus, can you game now? No.
No, I have to fill up my... Oh! I think I finished filling it. All right, I'm gonna try to power it on. You ready? Okay, there's some unfortunate news, though. The laptop is crazy quiet. But this thing is freaking loud. Okay, let's see if we can solve that. I would not recommend filling it all the way because this vent here, yeah, you see that? It stays open. I am super confused right now. There's no way it is supposed to be this loud. So we can monitor the fan, but can we control the fan? Not that I can see. What a letdown. I am so disappointed right now. Shut up! You know? Just shut up, shut up. Shut it up, just shut up, you know? Just shut up. With the complexity of this board in here, it seems like it should be able to handle fan control. Okay, Alex, I'm doing it. Here's what we're gonna do.
What are you doing?
I'm controlling the fan speed and I'm controlling the pump. I'm getting them both at a reasonable level. Are you seriously changing game settings right now while I have my thumb freaking burning on a fan.
Okay, so let's see. CPU hit a maximum of 80 degrees, although it seems like it was drawing, what, an average of 55 watts instead of the 45 that it was before.
That's cool. How's our GPU doing?
GPU max of 66.9, so that's way better.
Yeah.
And it's been drawing 127, looks like average 125. So about the same, although that's probably okay. Just power limited.
Well, I just am so let down right now.
It sounds broken.
It really does sound broken, I think. It must have just broken shipping.
Yeah, it might be broken. So I have confirmed that it is broken and should not sound like that.
Cool. But that doesn't account for that it has no speed control.
What is working though, it works great. Like, look at this.
Yes, this is wonderful. It's a lot better.
It's a lot. Like, look at this. Sustained 100 watts on the CPU. It was like 50 before.
Yeah.
It's a massive difference.
That's pretty cool. Looks like it's helping out the CPU the most.
Well, I'm guessing the GPU temps are way lower.
Oh, for sure.
Yeah.
Womp womp. That's awesome, like 58 degrees.
Massive drop in GPU temps and literally doubled your CPU power. Like, not bad.
Just has to work.
Yeah.
Not a perfect product, but when it works, boy, is this ever a fast laptop that gets even faster when you hook it up to the external cooling system. They've just definitely got a couple of little wrinkles to iron out. Just like I always iron my Segways smooth.
Get the best prices and best selection on computer hardware and everything else technology at any one of Micro Center's 25 locations across the United States. Check out the Micro Center Custom PC Builder to spec out the best PC for your budget. It'll help you ensure all your parts are compatible, find stock available at your nearest Micro Center, then you can just add it to your cart and arrange for same-day in-store pickup. For a fee, you can check the box marked Same-Day Pro Assembly, and one of Micro Center's expert technicians will assemble your PC for you. If you want help deciding what parts to put in your new custom gaming PC, join the online Micro Center community. It's a great place to discuss tech with other enthusiasts. New Micro Center customers can get a free 240GB SSD at the link down below. No purchase necessary, valid in-store only, limit one coupon per customer.
If you guys enjoyed this video, go check out the one where we water-cooled an Alienware with a weird thing we found on AliExpress. It cost way more and didn't work nearly as well. I really think they're onto something. This has got iron wrinkles.